Hi everyone, it's Shane David. Welcome back to the channel. Today we are going to a Korean baseball game.
It's time to baseball. This is what it looks like when the home team is winning the game.
It's our last full day in Seoul, South Korea, so come explore with us.
Before the baseball game though, we're gonna go to K-pop Street, which we just discovered on Google Maps, and it looks like the equivalent of like the Walk of Fame or the Hans Street in Hong Kong. So we're gonna go see what it's about and explore around.
Now usually Shay gets our tickets here, but I'm gonna try and do it right now. Here we go. So we're noticing the similarities between Japan and Korea, South Korea, and one of the things is there's no garbage cans anywhere, so my pockets are filled with garbage, more than they usually are.
Here we are! This is what Gangnam Style is.
Saying this reminds us of Rodeo Drive in California because there's all the fancy stores. We have Citibank, Saint Laurent, and some other ones. This is apparently the most famous K-pop band here. It's called BTS. And again, you might have heard some of their songs. Look at how big this Prada is. Wow. Okay, so this is crazy. Back home we have scooters, like e-scooters you can rent just to ride around the city. But they have actual scooters, like full-on mopeds that you can ride. And you just scan the barcode. How cool is that? We might have to do that later.
We found the neighborhood called Gangnam, which really explains the song Gangnam Style, because this is a very bougie neighborhood.
How does that explain it?
Because Gangnam Style, Gangnam, like the rich neighborhood, they have style, like bougie, stylish, Gangnam Style.
Okay, well, it was very interesting to see all those little cute figurines. Again, Korea is so cute. And now we're gonna go find some food for the baseball game. Woohoo! What do you know about baseball?
Not very much.
Okay.
Okay, we made it to the sports complex where the baseball game is. We're gonna try and find where some tickets are. We had to take a bus to get here, and the bus driver was not happy with us because we thought we could pay with cash, and apparently the buses here have gone cashless and you can only use a transit card or an app that we didn't have. So some nice lady on the bus was super nice and she offered to pay for us, and David's gonna reenact the sigh he did when we asked to pay for with cash.
So we got on the bus and she gets on there, she goes cash, and she goes Visa, and he goes like this. And then the nice lady offered to pay for us. It was hilarious.
Yeah.
But on to bigger and better things, let's go see if we can find a ticket. Well, I know just as much about baseball as I do on how to speak Korean, so it's gonna be very interesting. Almost just like the Korean movie where I didn't understand anything either. Thank you. It's interesting. Water.
Oh, there he is.
Hey.
My water.
It's like a fun tradition here. They let you bring drinks into the stadium, so everyone goes to this convenience store and you get a couple of drinks and then bring them in. Unlike back home where a drink is $30 and you can't go in and out of the stadium. Pretty cool. Okay, now we're trying to find our way into the stadium. We don't know it, so we're just gonna find the closest entrance.
It's like when the home team is winning the game. Watch this.
So fun. Everybody is singing and dancing. We have no idea what they're saying, but Koreans really know how to have fun.
Okay, we just left the stadium. That has got to be the most fun thing we've ever done in our lives, and the most fun sporting event. Koreans really know how to have a good time.
Yeah. I've never seen such an enthusiastic group of people watching a sports game.
I would pay just for the dancing and singing.
Yeah, we don't even know what happened with the baseball game, honestly. The dancing and singing was the main attraction.
Yeah. So we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.